Hallo everyone en welkom back voor een nieuwe toplijst. With this time the top 8 rainbows of Mario Kart. Every Mario Kart has them as the last race of the game in Rainbow World. With all, and I'm going to count down all 8 of them. Please keep in mind that I don't have all games, so the videos will be from other YouTubers. Also, this is my opinion, so your opinion can be completely different. However, if you want to let me know which your favorite Rainbow World is, let me down know in the comments. Without further ado, let's go. Number 8, Wii U Rainbow World. Well, let's face it, this is definitely not my favorite Rainbow World. In all honesty, this Rainbow World is not fun to drive to at all. The track is just too wide, and it doesn't feel like a real Rainbow World. So yeah, it is down to number 8 place, and I think it only deserves that kind of spot. I don't think it deserves any higher, so yeah. This is my least favorite Rainbow World of all of them. Number 7, the Rainbow World of the Game Boy Advance. Well, this Rainbow World is also not that good. It is better than the Rainbow World on the Wii U, that's one is for sure, because this at least is difficult to drive on. But other than that, this track is just completely fat with actually all of the tracks of the KBRR. So yeah, I must say I have never played this game, so maybe if I play it then it will be up a little bit higher, but in all honesty, this Rainbow World is definitely not my favorite. Number 6, the Rainbow World on the DS. I must say this is actually the first Rainbow World I ever played. And it is actually a great Rainbow World, because from now of them, I love them all. Yeah, and this is only 6, because the other ones are just better in my opinion. Sorry also about the lag in the video, it's sometimes paused, but yeah, this Rainbow World is really fun to drive on, and it is just a really good Rainbow World, and really fun to drive on, because all rainbows must be difficult to drive and felt like a real Rainbow World. Number 5, Mario Kart Rainbow World from Mario Kart Double Dash. Well, this one is actually a bit larger than the DS Rainbow World. And it is also a bit more difficult, at least I think it is, because just like the KBR, I never played this one, but it really looks really fun, and it really gives you the high hopes. It is really a Rainbow World, which I actually do prefer to see in the remake of Mario Kart 9 or than the KBR version instead, because this Rainbow World actually looks really cool, so. And I really hope to play this Rainbow World once in my life. Number 4, the Rainbow World of Mario Kart 64. Well, okay, let's be honest. This Rainbow World is not the difficult of all time, but it is famous because of the length and because of the kind of glitch it has at the very beginning. And also I do like the part that the Rainbow World is not completely flat, which actually was pretty rare for that time, because actually games on the Nintendo 64 were mostly just fun, but let's face it, this Rainbow World is famous because of its glitch, which makes it actually easy to skip the most part of the level by just after the start finish line to jump over the wheel and to shortcut the half of the circuit. Mostly out it didn't work, because it is very hard to do, but that is what makes this track that much fun to drive on. Number 3, Rainbow World of Mario Kart Wii. This Rainbow World is actually maybe the most favorite out of there, because this is by people mostly showing us the most as the best Rainbow Road. And I can completely see why, because this Rainbow Road is actually really, indeed really well. You're really in space and you're really driving Rainbow Roads. So yeah, this, also with the meteors floating in the air, it makes just this Rainbow Road indeed much better than it was on the DS. And I must say, I like the DS version though, but this one is actually that much cooler. And after our release and my number 2, you will maybe know what the number 1 is. So what do you guys think? Will it be the SNES or the 3DS version, which I do prefer? Number 2, 3DS Rainbow Road. So now you know that the SNES Rainbow Road is my favorite Rainbow Road out of all of them. However, this Rainbow Road is not really a Rainbow Road. Actually, they completely mixed up the Rainbow Road. But we must say in a good way, because this Rainbow Road, you actually start off on the kind of Rainbow Road, then you go to the moon, if I remember right, and then go in another part of space, but I don't remember which one. I think you drive on, yeah, you also drive on the rings of Jupiter sometime. I forgot what came first, but that does not matter. And actually, we want this Rainbow Road. I did say I do prefer the Rainbow Road of Double Dash see remaked, but in all honesty, the remake that I want the most in Mario Kart 9 is actually the 3DS Rainbow Road, because it looks so great. I think I'm even going to write a letter to Nintendo to ask if we not can have this Rainbow Road. Dear Nintendo, give us 3DS Rainbow Road. I think I completely misspelled that. Anyway, this is not my most favorite Rainbow Road out of there, but it comes pretty close. You know what my number one is, so let's go right on to that. Number one, the Rainbow Road from the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. This track just has it all. It is difficult, challenging, it might be flat, but this track, one mistake and you're off. It is a kind of similar to Monaco Formula 1. I think that's it enough. I almost forgot. Thank you guys for watching. And hopefully till the next week, we'll have a new top in gameplay for you guys ready.